How are you going? I just flew back to Australia after doing a boxing match and other things in America.
Many bags look alike. Please check your bag to ensure you're picking up the correct one. When removing your luggage, please keep hands and feet away from the carousel. Have a great day.
And some of you may be surprised to see me back here looking this unharmed and alive. Even after everything that's happening over there. And that's because I discovered the solution to living in America. All we need to do is make every man, woman, and most importantly, school child, bulletproof at all times. Alright, so I forgot to film this part of the video in America, so please just pretend I'm there right now. And I reckon I'm going to try a bunch of different methods of stopping bullets. First, I'll make myself a brand new bulletproof apron, but we'll also see if there's a poor man's solution, like just wearing all your shirts at once, or by converting to Christianity and carrying multiple religious books on your body at all times. But first, I'm going to start by making the bulletproof apron. Now I could just modify my old aprons, but they are covered in blood, falling apart, and have a slight smell of poo. So I may as well make a new one from scratch with real leather. And luckily William Osman has some, and invited me to come over and take the leather he harvested himself.
Come on over. Yeah, I can go to yours.
Come on over.
Yeah, alright, I'll come over now.
And honestly, I have no idea where to start turning this pile of skin into an apron. So, I took it to a man that has worked in the leather industry for 40 years. And he did give me some good advice on making an apron, but after he took literally 10 minutes to cut it in half with scissors, I figured I'm gonna have to do this myself. So I placed down my old apron and traced around it, avoiding any holes in the leather. And with this new apron, I'm gonna make a couple of changes to the shape to better suit my needs. And then I cut out the whole thing using a pizza cutter. And honestly, this apron is kind of done already. You know, I really didn't need that tiny man to help me make this. And now I just need to do some sewing, which I suck at. But luckily, I have someone else that can help me. William Osman's hot mum, who lent me her sewing machine, leather punches, riveting stuff, and most importantly, her hands. Her soft, clean, warm hands.
Push it like you're pushing by a half.
So now that I slightly know how to sew, I folded down the edges of the apron, which will help protect it, and then placed some sticky tape down and some glue, and then sewed around the whole thing, being very careful not to prick my fingers. And look at that, perfect. Then I looked at my old apron and the new one and realized exactly what I was missing. These stitches in the middle, which were on the original as it was made of three pieces of leather, which mine is not. But I'm still gonna put down these pointless stitches so it matches. And that actually looks pretty good. Okay, next I need a way to hold this leather to my body. And luckily, William Osman's mum is also an experienced stripper and gave me this strip cutting machine, which cuts up the cow skin in the same way as a pasta maker. Then once it was cut, I boiled it in salty water until al dente, and then riveted in place with one strap on the top and then one on the back with some latches on it. And now the apron is aesthetically done. But just like the cow it was made from, it's not bulletproof yet. And to do that part, I'm gonna use this stuff, which is meant to be Kevlar, but surprisingly looks exactly like a towel. So I hope the man in the store wasn't trying to get me shot. And I didn't properly plan out how many layers I need, so I can only fold it 8 layers thick if I want to get full coverage of the Kevlar on the apron. And horrifyingly, it was very easy to poke the scissors through the Kevlar, which isn't giving me faith this is gonna work. And this actually feels pretty great and isn't much heavier than my old apron. It also looks pretty good and looks expensive compared to my old one, except it is missing one thing. The familiar smell of poo and dirt from my old apron. So I fixed that. And it's done. So now I just need to shoot myself. And luckily, I have the perfect person to help me. And our first option was to just head down to the local school. But then we realized it was a weekend. So instead, we went to a Denny's car park and put 50 shirts on me.
You put this on?
Who's the model?
This is just 3 shirts and already bad.
All right, we're moving on to the medium-large pile.
What shirt are you on?
This is my 4th shirt. This is already bad. Maybe if I put my hands up.
Just kind of shoot it in.
You've become noticeably bigger.
Already?
Yeah.
I can't put my arms down to the side. This is as much as I go down.
Do I look bigger?
Yeah.
I can feel it in my neck.
Can you get it on?
How can I do that?
Here you go.
Can you breathe?
I can breathe, but not when I put my arms on.
And if you're wondering where I got this many shirts, let's just say there's going to be over 100 really cold homeless people in LA tonight.
You got like a hump in the back.
Do you boys want to go get some Denny's?
Yeah, let's go to Denny's.
And after putting as many shirts on me that felt safe, which was only around 30, we bought some Denny's for the road and started the long journey to William's mate's place. And now that I have 30 shirts on me and feel like I'm about to pass out, it's the perfect time to hear from today's sponsor, NordVPN. I've been using NordVPN for years, and it allows me to comfortably and safely use the internet as it protects all my data and web activity. This was me before, using the internet without Nord, naked and afraid with no protection. But now, I have NordVPN, and I'm super protected with multiple layers of security. NordVPN protects all of your internet data behind a wall of next-generation encryption. Nord is incredibly useful for me, especially when I'm in America or want to access my accounts back home in Australia without triggering annoying security and getting my accounts locked. It's also great for changing locations in the world, getting faster internet speed, and safely accessing public Wi-Fi. So go now to get an exclusive NordVPN deal at nordvpn.com/IDidAThing. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. That's nordvpn.com/IDidAThing. Okay, back to the hot car.
Are you going to try to get out?
Yeah, I mean, I can't. Well, can you help me open this door?
The door doesn't open. We've been over there.
Why does this not open?
Because it's jammed up right there.
You look like a slug. Are you going to make it?
Howdy, George. There you go. Nice and easy. There, good.
You okay?
It's nice and hot out here. Exactly what I wanted.
How are you feeling? You've been in that outfit for like 40 minutes.
You feel bulletproof?
Yeah. Let's go shoot me already.
And I very quickly realized a problem with this video idea. I was struggling to breathe, very uncomfortable, and overheating. But luckily, William's mate stuffed some ice packs down my back.
This feels good.
Can you feel any of the other ones?
Yeah, dude. My back is so nice now.
And then took us down a mountainous path into a beautiful valley where we could all shoot me without anyone complaining about the noise. But unfortunately, Alan Pan wasn't down with the idea and offered his human torso fleshlight as a substitute.
Yeah.
Is that what you meant by slapping around?
Exactly. It's getting a little
bit. Is this enough, Alan?
Keep going. A little bit more. Yes.
Which we strapped to a chair and then put 30 shirts on top of. Before I shot my first ever gun, a .22.
I'm starting to feel like this isn't gonna stop anything.
This is my first time shooting a gun.
You didn't hit
Let's hope there isn't.
Right in the heart.
Come on. I don't like the fact that I cannot feel a bullet behind that.
Oh, well, dude, there's not an exit hole on the other side.
Yeah, but that's because
it's stuck in the gel.
You gotta go higher.
If it's caught in the back shirt, that means that you just need double
that's,
this amount
that's
of shirt.
The wound right there.
That's right.
Is that
yeah.
it?
You yeah. see that line? Yeah, that's yeah. the.
And we couldn't find the bullet, but I think that's because it went straight through the 30 shirts, the torso, and out the other side. So we need some more shirts. And because we left the rest at the top of the hill, we just put 30 shirts in front to make 60 layers.
I squeezed and nothing happened.
I saw it go in.
You did?
I swear to God, if you hit my GoPro.
I thought you said hit your GoPro.
No, Doug, did you hit my GoPro?
Where'd you see it hit, Alan?
It looked all dead center, dude.
Oh,
here.
Yeah.
And it went right out this side and it came out
no!
my GoPro.
Did it go? Oh! Oh! Look, you can see the red from the shirt makes it look like blood, too, dude.
It dude, and straight out the other side.
It's so clear where both of these rounds entered and exited.
But look at all of these little fragmentations, too.
Oh yeah.
So that bullet actually fragmented and still hit
and still
in multiple spots.
So in a way the shirts made it worse.
And his arm fell off.
Yeah. Hey, that's expensive.
That was a dumb idea. We don't have any more shirts. Unless
yeah,
you boys
your
gonna
bike
take
it.
What if you fold each of these shirts in half? So it's 120 shirts.
So we did exactly that. I'd folded them in half again to make 120 layers of shirts.
There you go.
Come on. Is that it? Please be it.
How dude, dead nut.
Do you think it went through? Yeah?
That was a good shot.
It was...
Oh, wait!
Wait.
No, this was here before.
Oh, was it?
You might have stopped that one.
No, I think this one was here before.
No, this... I remember this one was here before.
Really?
I think... There's no... Wait, where's the exit hole? Dude, I think you're gonna find a bullet somewhere in here.
Just shake it. Oh, there
it is. Oh, right here!
Yeah!
Right here, dude!
Yeah!
120 shirts!
Oh!
And that finally stopped the bullet and answers the stupid title of this stupid video. It would take around 120 shirts to catch a bullet. So let's move on to something else, testing religions, and see which one you should be a part of if you want to survive living in America. And first up, the Mormons.
I got.
There you go.
I think all you did was put the Book of Mormon inside the man.
I don't think it stopped it.
I don't think that stopped anything.
Oh no.
This is what.
Which hole is it?
This one.
God, Will loves the.
He loves feet. Why are you?
He was doing this with the glove gun too.
Who I would not put my faith in. Okay, next we have two religions that work really well with each other. Good old Christianity and colon hygiene.
Okay, 3, 2.
Oh,
wow, dead center, right in the.
I had the guy jiggle, so I don't think either of those religions helped at all.
That is so center.
Dude, I think you might actually have gone right through his real colon.
Oh no, I like it that books are now joined together.
Oh my god!
What?
Find the exact page that it stopped on, that's your new religion.
You didn't, no, I think the bullet's back. Okay, how do
there
we find?
There it is!
How do we find?
Okay.
Diet and constipation!
Okay.
With very rare fruits contain a considerable amount of organic acids. I think this is our sign we need to eat more fruit, boys.
So, all you need is this over your heart at all times.
Over your whole body.
Yeah, you're gonna need a lot more than a Bible to save.
All right, I'm ready.
So we stopped there and now finally moved on to my apron, which I'm gonna shoot first with a 22, as that is the most common round used in America, but more importantly, is the only round that it has a chance of stopping.
Come on. 3, 2, 1.
I couldn't tell where you hit that.
Come on.
I hope it went through.
Oh, hey, there's the hole.
Oi!
Oh my god! Just
wait, what
barely!
The heck?
Oh, it must have been folded up.
Oh, it was folded up.
But it stopped it on
It stopped it on the first one. That's insane. It went through.
It didn't go through.
Wait, it didn't go through the first. Holy.
Dude, Kevlar's awesome.
Wait, what the heck? That's insane. That's awesome.
Wait, you could actually like shoot yourself with that. Like, wait, wearing
one,
that.
One layer.
And it actually stopped a 22 hollow point very easily. So I moved on to some normal 22 rounds.
Uh-oh.
Okay, well, we've got one.
Wait, there's
there.
One! Oh, dude! No,
I think they're all in there.
Kevlar's way better than t-shirts.
Who would have known?
Oh, wait, look at that's that.
Look
so
at
cool.
How it caught it. Gave it a little G-string, like. Okay, wait,
where's
is this
the
interesting?
Other one?
Okay, there's another one.
Oh, nice! That is so
it's
dope.
It's interesting that some go quite a lot deeper.
And that went through more layers, but it still stopped them. And who would have guessed that a fabric that is manufactured to stop bullets stopped bullets better than normal t-shirts? So we then decided to move onto the big rounds and shoot it with a slug.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. Oh!
That's not looking good
right
for the guy.
Although I think you might hit low. Oh wait, no, that was right on it.
Dude, that's like a nice little circle through the front of the...
Yeah, let's take a look at the Kevlar.
Wait, hold it, hold it.
I reckon it stopped. Dude, I barely hit the Kevlar.
This
oh!
Straight through,
it
though,
didn't do
dude.
Anything.
Dude, that's horrific.
Yeah, dude, slug. 12-gauge slug.
That is a big, hot,
get
warm
it.
Hole.
Oh, you can get a figure. Oh, dude, that feels,
oh yeah,
that
I
want to
feel
rock.
The warm hole. Oh, yeah.
Can we touch?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
This feels sexual.
I can feel you.
I feel like one of these books over here says you're not allowed to do shit yeah. like that.
And the apron did absolutely nothing. But we decided to keep shooting it anyway and do the only thing men actually want to do and shoot my cock off.
Oh, hey! Dude, you got it. That's my dick.
Oh,
is that not my dick?
And there you go. All the American kids watching finally know how to protect themselves. All you do is put on 120 shirts before you go to school. And now that I have my bulletproof apron, I can finally make the video I've waited my whole life to film.